You are now listening to Vigilantes Radio, presented by the Only One Media Group. This is the people's choice for quality interviews, celebrities, and special guests. Hosted by Demetrius Dinny Reynolds. Call in to join the mix at 701-801-9813. For the complete archive of episodes, visit onlyonemediagroup.com and be sure to like us on Facebook at Vigilantes Radio. We welcome all. Enjoy the show. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome your host, Demetrius Houdini Black Reynolds. Enjoy the show.
Hello, hello, hello. What is going on, guys? Welcome to another incredible episode of Vigilantes Radio Live right here on iHeartRadio. And I am your host, Dini. We have a very special guest for you guys, so you definitely want to stick around for that. And as a matter of fact, text your buddies, family members, or even share it on social media right now and let them know that we are about to dive deep into another interview. Before I bring my guest on, I do want to say, you know, the most reliable way of being in the right place at the right time is to prepare yourself for it. Great opportunities are everywhere, and the people who benefit the most from them are those who are the best prepared. Preparation can be tedious, and it's not usually very exciting. The results it brings can be tremendously exciting, though. Being sufficiently prepared will open doors for you that you otherwise would never see. The time and effort you spend learning, practicing, developing your skills, and laying the groundwork for achievement may not pay off immediately, but those efforts spent in preparation will indeed pay off, and when they do, they'll pay off in a big way. Your time is never wasted when you spend it to become better prepared. Athletes win because of practice, and businesses succeed because of the skills their people have developed. Those who achieve do so because they have prepared themselves to achieve. There's no better way to genuinely confidently know that you're prepared. Do your homework, lay the groundwork, build a solid foundation, be prepared, and become truly confident. When you're prepared, great opportunities will virtually jump out at you. And the best thing is, you'll be ready for them. Take that from me, Coach Denny. That is my word. Let's go.
Ooh-wee, ooh-wee, ooh, yeah. Wow.
This is the voice of Dominic Tony, here to invite you to see me perform live, May 25th at the North Hills Dive Bar and Grill.
See Dominic Tony live May 25th at the North Hills Dive Bar and Grill. Dominic Tony live May 25th at the North Hills Dive Bar and Grill. Showtime starts at 8 p.m. For more information on how to book Dominic Tony to perform in your venue, go to www.dominictony.com.
Don't miss out on a night to remember. Come make some memories with me. And remember, folks, you ain't heard nothing yet.
All right. Again, welcome to the show. You're listening to VRL. That's Vigilantes Radio Live right here on iHeartRadio. And I am your host, Dini. Our interviews are designed to go beyond the music, news, books, art, acting, films, technology, education, entrepreneurship, entertainment, and sometimes even past that thing that we call the ego. Our interviews are designed to go behind the scenes and into the minds of these incredible human beings. You know, the ones who were out there giving it their all for me, for you, and for the world. Well, ladies and gentlemen, be prepared to be whisked away on an enchanting journey through the power of storytelling, myths, and the human psyche with the extraordinary Dr. Nina M. Kelly. With a career that spans the realms of Jungian psychology, mythological exploration, and heartfelt humanitarian efforts, Dr. Kelly has touched lives around the globe. Her passion for the art of storytelling not only heals, but also brings to light the silent heroes among us. Whether it's through her best-selling books, impactful documentaries or her dedication to cultural and arts activism, Dr. Kelly's work is a beacon of inspiration and compassion. So guys, get ready to be inspired. And with that, let's welcome Dr. Kelly to our show. Good morning. How are you?
Good morning. I'm fine, thank you. And thank you for having me on your radio this morning.
Absolutely. It's an absolute honor to have you here with us today. I guess we should start on your journey. You know, it is incredibly fascinating. Could you share with us what initially sparked your passion for storytelling and mythology?
Well, I think it's just called time on earth and listening to stories. And, you know, I came from a background. I'm from New Orleans, and by that nature, we love music and stories and food, and that's just part of the journey. But also, in growing up, I remember very distinctly listening to other people's stories and just the passion of living. And that, I think that in itself encourages you and wants you to share what you've learned along the way.
Yeah, how were you able to woven those things, that those passions into your career?
Well, today we're talking about, or I'd like to speak about this book, Grace Has a Silent Voice, and these are true stories, and that incorporates the portion of my life I spent working with death and dying, organ donation, transplantation, and spent a lot of time with individuals. And because of that, I really wanted to, you hear a lot of stories, and I wanted to share their stories because their stories inspired me, and I saw their resilience in the most critical times of their life. I thought, what great stories, what great inspiration, and they truly are the silent heroes. You know, they go about doing their life, and their life makes profound differences in other people's lives, whether they realize it or not. So that's all part of storytelling. Mm-hmm. You know, or story sharing is actually a good word.
You know? Yeah. Speaking of the book, it's called Grace Has a Silent Voice. And in your remarkable journey, Dr. Kelly, I'm sure you've encountered stories of resilience, courage, and the human spirit. And reflecting on these experiences and also the stories inside of the book, what would you say is truly worth fighting for in life?
Oh, I think it's your passion. I could say that without even... When you're passionate about anything, I'm going to sidetrack for just a second. I loved your introduction to this program because I thought, wow, what an inspiration. That's also another part of story. You know, you're giving someone else inspiration. And I think, to me, that's what gets you up every morning to see with a clear lens of the world around you and then just go after it. You know, don't let anything stop you from what you believe in.
Have you ever had any... Oh, and thank you, by the way.
You're welcome.
Have you had any things or someone try to stop your passion?
Oh, absolutely. People go, oh, are you kidding me? What are you doing this for? Why? You know, oh, yeah, you have to. You know, the bottom line is I think we all have this little burning fire in us. Sometimes we get a little sidetracked, but that's also a call of life. But that desire stays with you, and at some point in time, it's going to creep its little head up and go, you know, I'm here, I'm going to do it. And that's that inner drive inside of oneself. Yeah. People do try to stop you. Yeah.
I wonder why, though. You know, I would think that other people would be busy with their own passions.
Yeah, you know, one would think. Sometimes, I'm going to be very candid here. I think sometimes down deep inside of us, we know what we have to do. It's easy for us not to do that. And so therefore, we get sidetracked and look at others. And, you know, that's getting off your railroad track. You know, I believe that we all have a journey. And it's my philosophy that you have an end goal. Sometimes you're really lucky if you get on it and you stay on that track, you go right to it. The majority of us don't. We go sideways around the bend, but eventually we still get to where we need to go. But in those sideways, sometimes there are others that try to discourage us because they're also sideways. And that there's nothing wrong with that. That's just all part of the journey. Sometimes it makes you even more rich in your belief system.
Absolutely, absolutely.
Yeah.
What does grace mean for you?
Wow. See, grace for me, it's just not one word or one thought. It's a whole experience of a lifetime. You know, I think, you know, the sun comes up in the morning. That's the grace of the earth giving us the sunrise. People smiling, that's another sign of grace. People giving and caring about one another, you know, loving your community, loving one another. Those are all big, to me, instruments of grace. And the reason, it's interesting, the reason why I call the book Grace Has, it came to me actually, Grace Has a Silent Voice, is because grace is everywhere and it speaks to us all the time. If we can just stop for a moment and listen.
Yeah. You know? And sometimes it's contagious because, you know, like me, I could wake up and say, oh man, I woke up this morning. That's a win.
Yeah. Amen, brother.
Yeah. And for me, that is grace because I didn't have to wake up. I didn't have to have another opportunity to get it right, you know. And then it's like, yeah, I was given this universal grace. Why don't I share it with somebody else or make somebody else's life just a little bit easier by showing them some grace?
Yeah, and I really appreciate your word contagious, because it really is contagious. You know, you get up, what's that song? You got to get up every morning, put a smile on your face. You know, mm-hmm. It's amazing when you do that. The whole energetic field shifts. People
yeah.
see you smile. Guess what? They smile. Next thing you know, everybody's, you know, smiling, and they have a different bounce to their foot, you know, to their step. I think it's great. Yeah.
That's right. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. And it's funny you say that you know, smiles on the face. Nowadays, a lot of times I see a lot of mean mugs or emotionless faces. And I'm like, hey, is everything okay? Oh, yeah, this is just my resting face. Like, yo.
My resting face.
Pack a smile or something. Do the Mona Lisa or something.
My resting face.
Yeah.
Yeah, I said, well, you might want to wake up.
And since I've noticed that, Dr. Kelly, I make sure my resting face has a little smile.
You know what? And I appreciate that because, you know, we don't think that. Those are, you know, it's just little thing, and that's a free thing. It didn't cost
yes.
you a dime to smile.
Exactly.
You know? Yeah, I love it.
Absolutely. So there's another thing that I'm interested in. It's Jungian mm-hmm. psychology. What is that exactly?
Well, Jungian psychology was, it's Carl Jung was a Swiss psychologist, and he actually worked with Sigmund Freud, long before they split. And what he did was he studied dreams and dream patterns. And then he also created the term archetypal patterns, archetypal psychology. And just to put it very simply, we wear many hats, and those are the archetypes. You can be a son, a father, a brother, a friend. Those are all different. A professional, you know, an announcer, a radio host. All in each one of those roles, we put on this persona. So we're wearing this hat, and we start living those roles, and they all define us. But that doesn't—we're not just one type. Like, I'm not just a mother. I'm not just a daughter. You know, I'm many different things, different aspects, and that makes you. It makes you complete. It makes you who you are, or what you put out into the world. You know. Jung didn't say this, but in New Orleans we have a saying, it takes many ingredients to make a great gumbo. And that's the same thing with a human being. It takes many ingredients of oneself to bring you to be the person who you really are. But that's all part of learning to and recognizing that we wear different hats. You know, we act different roles in life. And he brought that to the forefront. Yeah.
Absolutely. And you've worked with deaf and dying patients, and that must have been profoundly moving. How has this experience influenced your storytelling?
I have to tell you, thank you for asking that question. When you walk that closely with death, then you really appreciate life. And I love when you said you wake up in the morning and go, wow, I didn't have to wake up. And so that means, you know, you really are recognizing you're alive.
See? Oh, yeah.
And when I had the privilege to have so many experiences like that, I realized how precious life is. And it's not that I don't take things for granted sometimes. I try not to, but we're human, you know, sometimes, you know. But I really appreciate life. And I appreciate the stories people have shared. And it's interesting about people, before they die, they're living the most vibrant, if it makes any sense, they're holding on to the very essence of life right before they pass on.
Wow. Wow. So what do you believe is the healing power in sharing and honoring these stories?
The older I become, the more I realize the passion of love. And it seems so trite to use the word love, but it's so much bigger than that. It's love, it's compassion, it's understanding, it's non-judgment, it's acceptance. It's all so encompassing. And you know, the thing about a baby has no judgment in their eyes. They just take everything in, and they're just grabbing it all in and learning. It's the beauty. If we humans can get to the point of, oh, wow, you come from this land and I come from that land. Wow, what can we learn from each other instead of trying to change each other? I think that's the greatest gift I've been given.
Absolutely. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. You're also an Amazon best-selling author.
Mm-hmm.
Have you had a chance to really take that in and celebrate that?
The answer is yes, no. Sometimes you go, wow, oh, okay, I've got to get better. You know, it's that driving force we have inside of us. And sometimes you're right. That's a great question, actually. Have you really embraced it? I love that. I think I sit with it, and yet maybe sometimes it hasn't become so cellular yet. It's like, and you know, bathe in that for a moment.
Yeah. Absolutely. All right, so the book is out now, right? Grace Has a Silent Voice.
Yes, it is. It's actually getting ready to go into its second edition. One of the feedbacks I've been given is, can you give us a little bit more about the stories? I had this desire to, there was these people just changed my life so profoundly. I mean, I saw the greatest gifts of humanity come at the moments of death. And so I wrote them down, and I call them the silent heroes, because I really wanted to honor the people that I wrote about. And obviously, because they're true stories, I can't give the true identity of the people, you know. Mm-hmm. But that's why it's called creative nonfiction. But every day we have stories, and it's the beginning of time, that's how we've existed. Sharing stories. Think about it. You go around and have dinner with people, and you go, "Let me tell you what happened." And we're all feeling. Our music is the same thing. Music's telling stories. You know, the rhythm of life. Yeah.
Is there a story in this book that is I won't say it's your favorite, but it has the most impact on you?
You know, I don't have a favorite in here because every story is different. They're all different people at different moments. But I'm going to go back and as soon as you asked me the first time, there was a Mr. Scott, which I just dearly love, and he was such a hero in my eyes, and I really respect him. And I was actually, that is his real name, because he gave me permission to use his name. So I really, he touches my heart, and always will. And then there's another story in there of a father that lost his wife and his child the same day. And to witness the tragedy, but yet the openness of his heart at the most difficult time in his life, he was able to think beyond himself. That's pretty profound. You know, I pray to God none of us ever have to go through that. But when you see and you witness somebody like that, that changes your life forever. Because, you know, how he was able to get beyond himself and hope and wish for somebody else to be able to live through his tragedy.
Absolutely.
Yeah. You can't get past that one. I mean, that's pretty, you know, that's beyond words even.
Oh, yeah.
Think about that. Yeah.
You know, there are advancements in technology and changes how we consume media now. How do you see the art of storytelling evolving? And, you know, yeah, how do you see the art of storytelling evolving?
And it's through media? Oh, my goodness. Well, I get, you know, media is so fast and furious. The running joke with me is I'm trying to get with the 21st century. You know, because it just changes so rapidly. But I think it's a great way. It's just like everything. It's a great opportunity to reach people you can't reach under normal circumstances. You know, once upon a time, we sat around let me use this as an example. You sit around the campfire, you know, and you're telling your stories. But now you can put the radio on or the TV on or you know, internet, and you have quick access. My only wish is that you have more good going out there. More, like the way you started your program today. You started off with inspiration. What a great way to kickstart. I really listened to that. I thought, wow, this is really good. Because you're starting with a positive note, with an encouraging note. This is how I hope media does, that it brings everybody to the best of their ability to strive for something beyond themselves.
Absolutely. Yeah. And thank you again for your kind words.
You are so true. We need more of that in the world.
Yes, we do. Yes, we do.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
And finally, for those inspired by your journey and looking to make their mark through storytelling, what advice would you give them to start their journey?
The exact word you just used, start. Don't be afraid, just start. If something inspires you, go for it. You know, just don't be afraid. Fear is a big handicap. And there's somebody waiting. There's someone waiting to hear what you have to say. There's someone waiting for an inspiration or giving them the courage like, oh, yeah, I have stories. Oh, yeah, maybe somebody wants to hear this one. So you're actually doing it for someone else. You're actually, I would hope, your gift is to give to someone else. That's what I feel storytelling is.
Absolutely. You've achieved a lot in your career. What's the next big project or challenge you're looking forward to tackling?
Well, I'm doing two things, right? You know, I write children's books as well. So I am writing a brand new children's book. And so that's the most immediate project right now. And then the next is just keep writing, keep pulling from my little time frame that I've spent on this earth and see where I can pull up and get back out, you know, see what happens. But it's to write, and it's to improve my craft.
Absolutely. And where can our listeners pick up a copy of the book and connect with you online?
Well, they can pick up a book at, obviously, Amazon and Barnes & Nobles, and actually any of their local bookstores. Grace has a silent voice. And then they can find me online. Go to my website, would be Nina, N-I-N-A-M, Kelly, K-E-L-L-Y.com, 9amkelly.com. And it will show you how to find the books and things that I've done and so forth and so on. And I really appreciate this interview. Thank you so much.
You're welcome. You're welcome. And listeners, just in case you need those links, no worries. I will have them in the description of this episode and in the show notes. So all you guys have to do is just click the links. Thank you so much, Dr. Nina M. Kelly, for being our special guest this morning. Your insights today have not only enlightened myself, but have also deeply touched my heart. Your dedication to exploring, your dedication to exploring the depths of human emotion, culture, and the healing power of stories is inspiring. And thank you for sharing your journey, your victories with us. To our listeners, we hope that today's conversation with Dr. Kelly has inspired you to find your own story, to listen deeply to the stories around you, and never underestimate the power of words and compassion. And until next time, keep seeking, keep sharing, and keep storytelling. Goodbye for now.
Oh, thank you. Thank you so much. I appreciate it. You have a great day.
We appreciate you. You as well. Thank you.
Take care. Bye-bye.
Bye.
Thank you, my Vigilantes family, as always, for checking out my podcast over here at Vigilantes Radio Live. All episodes are available for free download, and you can grab it from either Spreaker.com/Only One Media Group, Spotify, CastBox, iHeartRadio, iTunes, YouTube, the app Podcast Addict, or over at our website, which again is onlyonemediagroup.com. And that goes for every single show that we've ever aired. If you like to request music or send something for me to play, email it to vradio@onlyonemediagroup.com. That is V as in Victor. And here's my disclaimer. We are genre free. We do not judge, and we absolutely do not base our opinions on hearsay, but facts alone. And actually, scratch all of that, because all of my opinions are always right. That's the bottom line. This is my show, so deal with it. Just kidding. On behalf of myself, Denny, I appreciate all you guys for tuning in, either afterwards or live with us. Spread the word, because sharing is caring. We stepped up our game just for you guys and our guests to make sure that you have the best experience here on our show. Be sure to connect with me on Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, Tumblr, Snapchat, TikTok, at all social media sites, as well as Spreaker, YouTube. We always follow back. Okay, well, just remember to put yourself into everything that you do and never stop investing in yourself. Peace, love, grilled cheese, and talk with you later.
You are now listening to Vigilantes Radio, the people's choice for quality interviews, art, music, and hot topics. Hosted by Demetrius Houdini Black Reynolds of the duo No Longer the Hero. All episodes of this podcast are available for free download at www.onlyonemediagroup.com. This is a Seventh Sign Regime, Rebirth Worldwide Syndicate exclusive.